Hi, I'm Jill from the Science Demonstration Theaters team at Carnegie Science Center, and welcome to the Something to Watch series, where we present fun and educational videos for kids, parents, and teachers. Now, like other Science Center team members, I'm currently at home practicing social distancing, so for the next 3 minutes, why don't we explore some kitchen science with an activity where you probably have everything you need to try it right now in your kitchen. All right, so we are going to be making a non-Newtonian fluid. Sound complicated? Well, here's what you're gonna need. Cornstarch and water. That's it. Because we are making Oobleck. Now, Oobleck gets its name from a Dr. Seuss book. However, I've also heard it called magic mud. Whatever you wanna call it, it's a super easy way to demonstrate some super cool science. Now, along with your cornstarch and water, you're also gonna want a bowl to mix things in. You're going to want a spoon maybe to help you mix. You're gonna want to have some measuring cups on hand. And if you wanna get really fancy, some food coloring. Okay, well, let's begin by pouring in 1 cup of cornstarch into our bowl. Notice how smooth the powder feels? That's because the cornstarch is made up of super fine particles. Okay, so now it's time to add the water. So you're gonna go ahead and pour about 1 cup of water into the bowl. And this is where you can start mixing. You can use a spoon if you want. Sometimes it's a lot easier to use your hands. And here's a pro tip. If you want to add a little color to your Oobleck, now is the time by adding some food coloring to the water. That usually makes it a little bit easier. So go ahead and pour that in. And we're going to try and stir things up a little bit. There we go. Now this is where you're gonna have to do a little experimenting. We want the mixture to be thick and kind of harden when you tap on it, but not too hard or too runny. You can always add more cornstarch if it's too watery. You can add more water if it's too thick. Generally, you're gonna use about 2 cups of cornstarch to 1 cup of water, but there we go. All right, so I think it's probably about the consistency we want. Now it's time to get messy. Do this. Try putting your hands in really slowly and then pulling them out really quickly. What happens? Go ahead, try grabbing some of the Oobleck in your hands and squeezing it, and then let go. What is going on? Is it a solid? Is it a liquid? No, it is a non-Newtonian fluid. Okay, so if we look at common liquids like water, all right, this is gonna get a little messy, but let me grab a spoon and my water glass. So if I take water and I stir it around, the viscosity or the thickness, it doesn't change. That's because it's a common liquid. But when we are dealing with non-Newtonian fluids, things are a little different. The viscosity or thickness of non-Newtonian fluids changes based on how much pressure you apply. So remember those fine particles in our cornstarch? Well, when you mix them with water, they become suspended. And if you apply force, the particles get kind of mashed together, trapping the water molecules between them and becoming solid temporarily. Because when you release the pressure, the particles spread out, allowing things to flow. Other non-Newtonian fluids include things like quicksand and silly putty, but you might be surprised how many you have around your house right now. Because guess what? Ketchup, yogurt, and hair conditioner are all examples of substances whose viscosity or thickness changes depending on how much pressure is applied. Now, if you've been to our Science Center around our Mess Fest celebration, you know we like to make vats of this stuff. But if you can't wait until then, why not go ahead and try making your own Oobleck at home right now? And be sure to log on to CarnegieScienceCenter.org for more things to read, more things to watch, and more things to do. Though you might want to wash your hands first.